Joining us in the studio this morning, we're getting both sides of the story, and we're going to hear his side in full. COMELEC Chairman Andy Bautista is with us this morning. Welcome to Hot Copy, Chairman. Thank you for coming to the show. I mean, it must have been very painful, on your end to watch that primer. And I want to ask you first, before we start, you must be in shock.
Well, not just shock, Karen, you know, really. Probably this is one of the most painful chapters in my life. You know?
Yeah.
And again, I feel I've not been dealt with fairly and forthrightly. And I'm here really to present my side and the side of my family. So please ask the questions and I will divulge the information that you would require.
All right. There are two important parts to this story. And first, it's you as a the chairman of COMELEC on unexplained wealth, because a domestic squabble that might turn into a possible crime, allegations of a crime, that's one. The other one is how this domestic issue was not handled on your own as a private person. So tell me your story. It seems that it's about a wife who's been wanting to separate from you, in which you will not settle with her. And then she finds documents, passbooks at home, which then puts your wealth in question, your credibility and your integrity.
Okay. So Karen, let me begin the story sometime in 2012, 2013. Okay. There was a rumor that came out that my wife was seeing another person. Okay. And that I don't want to belabor that point. Okay. The fact is, though, that she has described this person as her soulmate. Now tell me, okay, if you are with somebody and yet you are told that your spouse has already found another soulmate, how would you feel? You know, at that point in time, we had four very young boys who needed their parents. I was advised already to file charges, but I couldn't do it because of the boys, because I recognized that for these boys to grow up properly, they needed a mother and a father. So basically, Karen, tinanggap ko yan, okay? Kung ano man dusa, ang nadulot niyan, sabi ko, kailangan kong tignan yung mas malaking kapakanan ng aking mga anak. Okay? Nung aking 50th birthday, and you know, the irony is, itong lalaking ito, pareho pa kami ng birthday. No? On my 50th birthday, she came to my party, but she was silent the whole time. But you know what? She didn't sleep in our house that night. And for the past 2-3 years, she has not been sleeping in our house 3 to 4 times a week. So basically, we are estranged, and I don't know what kind of a relationship they have, no? But all I know is that they see each other on a regular basis in a condominium in Salcedo 3.
Until today. Because she denied that yesterday.
Well, as I said, we will have, at a later date, we will show pictures, we will show logs. But again, as I said, that was my dilemma, okay? Na dapat ba kaming maghiwalay at that point in time? Sabi ko, mas malaki ang kahalagahan ng aking mga bata. Okay? At ang gusto ko kahit na paano, alam ko naman na mahal niya ang mga bata at mahal na mga bata siya eh. Kaya ayoko din naman tanggalin yun eh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, we go now 2016. No?
Yeah.
I was an observer in the US elections. I was invited by the US government. Okay? On November 10, I got a call from my bank here saying that she was withdrawing $117,000 and 250,000 pesos from our joint account and transferring it to her personal account.
Okay.
I tried to call her. She did not want to take my calls. Okay? On my way back, my sister got a text from her saying that she had engaged counsel and that the counsel had advised her to tell me though not to go home until this matter is settled. She sent some clothes to my sister's condo and said I should sleep there first.
And counsel was Attorney Lorna Capunan then?
That's correct.
Okay.
Oh. And then what happened was, okay, I really felt aggrieved. I wanted to go home. My sister said, keep calm. I am told that if you go home, they will call the media. I said, for what? What have I done? I said, anyway, early next day, I went home. When I got home with my sister, there were two armed guards, goons, in front of my condo unit, okay? And the condo doors were locked. We were being prevented from entering my own home. No? And that, nagmakaawa kami, sabi namin doon sa mga maid, papasukin niyo lang kami, may kukunin akong mga gamit dahil kailangan ako pumasok, gusto ko naman mag-shave, etc., etc., dahil hindi pinadala. Okay? For 2 hours, pinaintay kami sa labas. I guess she was calling her lawyer, and in the end, she realized that there was no legal basis for her to prevent me from coming to our home. In which case, pinapasok kami. Pagkapasok namin, okay, nagpunta ako sa banyo, nakita ko yung aking mga locked cabinets na binuksan ng pwersahan. At kinuha ang mga dokumento, kung ano-ano. You know, there was cash there, GCs, ATM, passbook, financial reports, etc., etc. No? Kinuhang lahat, iPad. Okay? At, you know, I was really shocked. And I said, did you get advice from counsel before you did this? And you know what she told me in front of my sister? Actually, it was upon the recommendation. You know, Karen, feeling ko talaga noon dati, akala ko ang babae lang ang pwedeng maggahasa. Feeling ko talaga, ako pala, isang lalaki, pwede ka rin palang maggahasa kung gagawin sa inyo. Parang, you know, my right to privacy, my right to my belongings. At itong mga bagay na ito ay hindi ko lang ari-arian. Ito din ay ari-arian ng aking pamilya, ng aking mga magulang, ng aking mga kapatid na alam niya. Okay? And that's why I stormed out. Okay? The following day, through a common friend, sabi sa akin, pare, ang balita ko, worth 2 billion pesos ka raw. Okay? At ang demand nila is 1 billion plus the 2 Pacific condo units. Sabi ko sa kanya, alam mo, kung ako worth 2 billion, sa kanila na lahat. Yung makikita mo eh, that they were really trying to set me up. They were trying to do an extortion play. Okay. Okay. Let me show you some documents. Yeah. No? This is a list of bank accounts, for example.
Yeah.
Okay, that they said I own.
No? All right. Can I put this here, hopefully, that it can be seen? So just to...
So
we're in the same page.
Right.
Yesterday, she took 32 passbooks coming from the Luzon Development Bank, which she says totals are roughly 300 million in deposits. Mm-hmm. So the first question I want to ask you, why would you have 32 passbooks?
Again, I don't know if I have 32 passbooks. You know ang problema dito, Karen, no? These documents were stolen. They have not been given back to me. It's been 10 months.
Okay,
since
so let's
this
say,
has happened, no? Now, I do...
Why do you have a lot of passbooks?
Again, because of the investments that I have together with my siblings and with my parents, we have to demarcate who owns which. Now, Karen, when we put it on TV, nakita ko kahapon yung ginawa, no? I don't think it's being fair to drag private people, you know, into this whole... medium, you know, again, these things should all be presented in court, not in media. Mm-hmm. You know, to me, really, there is an orchestrated campaign against me, perhaps against COMELEC, maybe against the elections, okay? Ang ano ko sana, punod nilun to, kung meron siyang ebidensya laban sa akin, kung gusto niya, pumunta kami sa Husgado.
Okay. No,
but I just wanted to show to you, no, just anecdotally, okay? Mm. Ito yung sinabi niyang mga accounts ko daw. No? Ito dokumento niya. Ito yung aking comment, no. Makikita mo dito sa mga accounts na ito, maraming iba yung amounts, maraming accounts closed.
So you have accounts closed.
Accounts closed. Shown? Yeah, yung kasi nga ang ginawa niya, pinagkukuhan niya yung mga dokumento doon. Hindi naman niya alam talaga kung ano yung mga dokumentong yun.
So it's fair to say that some of those passbooks, the accounts have been closed.
A lot. Yun nga.
Okay.
And then yung mga iba daw fake. Eh. No knowledge, I said here. Oh, yung No knowledge.
In fact, to be fair to your wife, I don't think she's capable of faking a passbook. That's quite complex.
Yeah, but again, to come up with this list, no, this list came from them of accounts. Again, and she kept on saying that she was the one who was preparing it. I don't think she was. There are people behind it who are doing that. And again, just to show good faith, you know, I issued these letters to the banks.
Can I just show, if you don't want details... just to show that you're saying that the banks have told you and confirmed that some of the accounts have been closed.
Closed? Or
yes.
Or they don't exist.
Yes, if you don't feel comfortable showing
this
part.
No, I think that's fair. Oh,
yeah.
Tapos
to show.
No knowledge.
Yeah.
Because hindi totoo yung mga bank accounts na yan.
So the passbooks brought on Head Start yesterday, which were shown, in other words, the banks, you've contacted the banks, and the banks themselves have answered those accounts?
Than me contacting the banks, okay? I gave her special powers of attorney. Go ahead and access the banks.
Ah, you did?
I did.
Okay. All right, so you gave her special power of attorney in December 2016 to access
the banks. To access and say, oh, kasi sinasabi ko mga false yan.
If it's false, why would they be there? Are you saying that the team behind her could have manufactured?
That's what I'm saying.
That, numbers?
Yes, sinasabi ko nga, Karen, ito ay isang kaso ng paningikil at panggigipit.
And falsification.
Falsification and all that stuff.
Okay.
And we will do that.
All right. So this is your authority for her to access all the accounts.
Well, again, as I said, there are certain accounts, okay, that are true. Maybe it's just the numbers. And I provided that to them. You know, the first person who was mediating between us was her own brother.
Yeah.
Okay. And what I suggested was, okay, let's go through the accounts and the properties one by one.
Mm-mm. Okay.
Okay, so that now, we can verify the authenticity and the amount.
All right.
She said, no. I just want a number. Oh. Give me a number that you're going to give to me.
Okay.
Because I just want to really get this over with and get my, you know, my share.
Okay. I'm going to ask you something that she said yesterday. She said that she was only asking at first for $150 million, which would have been 90 for her, 60 million for the kids. And then I think it moved up to 260 million, not 620. That's what she said yesterday on the show. But you held the settlement for ransom by demanding that, one, she signs a document that would say she found nothing irregular, and two, to help you disbar Lorna Kapunan. Which part is true?
Both untrue.
You never asked her?
Never asked her to do this. Okay, and again, okay, I will show it in. Okay. First, yung sa
260.
Okay. Let me show you a document. And again, maybe this is a public document.
So this is, I think we have this on the studio. I think it's on graphics too. For the viewers to see it, this is from the Kapunan Law Office. Mm. All right. And what does it say?
Well, okay, there you go. This is what they're asking for. And look at the numbers, okay?
Okay.
First installment is how much?
200 million.
Okay.
Okay. And then also the property, the family
which
residence.
Which is 120, 60 each.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then second installment upon filing for divorce in Hong Kong, another 200 million. So that's 400. And then a third installment upon the issuance of the divorce decree, 500 million.
Okay. So plus 120.
620.
That's the 620 number. Okay. Ah. That was in February.
But then I think we need to show because Patricia yesterday said, you're imagining things in effect that it was 620.
Okay.
When it was just 260.
I am providing you right now with a document.
Yes. Okay. Signed by Lorna Kapunan of 620.
That's correct. Okay. Now you're telling me that, well, you know what?
Could it be possible that your wife doesn't know this and the lawyers know
this?
Well,
again, I don't know about that. Okay. But what I'm saying is this also. She supposedly fired Kapunan.
Yeah.
She's changed lawyers. I don't know if she told that on TV.
She did. She said that now Attorney Kapunan works as a legal advisor and a friend, but not as her lawyer anymore.
Okay, let's go now to what her new lawyer texted me. No.
All right, so this is dated for just factual purposes. February 7, 2017, this is the demand for settlement coming from Attorney Lorna Kapunan.
On behalf of her client.
On behalf of Patricia, a total of 620 million.
That's correct. All right. Okay. Now, the new lawyer, I think he was here yesterday,
yes.
Martin Loon, we met several times,
you
know? And he's a friend. And I really thought he was a friend who was really concerned about my children. He kept on telling me about how he does not want my children to go through the same things that his half-brothers had to go through because of what happened to his father.
Yeah.
And I believed him. But I ask him now, with what's happening, you know, my kids don't go to school anymore. Because you know, they're being bullied. Again, is that being fair, Martin Loon? You know, it's all, he's two-faced, okay? The 620 was also there.
Okay.
Okay, you know, he told me, sir, this is just a speeding ticket. You can go on with this settlement. And I said, Martin, it's 620.
Yeah.
What you're asking for from me is 620.
So when Martin Loon was saying yesterday that you mentioned the 620, not him, would it be possible that he and Lorna Kapunan are not on the same page?
No, on the contrary, they may be on the same page.
Okay.
That they may be continuing to, you know, to work with each other.
Okay, so just for the record, you did not invent or offer a 620 figure.
I did not, okay? And in fact, this is what was offered. This is a term sheet of a settlement agreement that we thought had been agreed upon. Again, mediated by a third-party friend. I wish to name him, but again, maybe he wants to be kept private. But at some point in time, I will ask his permission, okay?
Okay.
But this is what is the term sheet.
And what is the date of the term sheet?
This is April 2.
Okay.
Here, okay.
All right. April 2, 2017. So this is more recent than actually Lorna Kapunan's demand letter, huh, which was
correct.
February.
That's correct.
This is April 2017. And just to summarize, the term sheet that was agreed upon totals
90 million.
Okay. That's okay.
And here, you know, you could see the numbers.
So 90 for your wife and then 60 for the kids. Am I correct?
Well, they get, in fact, the condo units. It will be in their names. So.
Okay. All right. And what happened after this? What went wrong?
Okay. What went wrong was that we thought we already had an agreement. Okay. We were trying to sign a common draft statement.
Okay.
Okay. And again, this thing about me making a condition, the disbarment of Kapunan, that's a falsehood. Okay. That's
and a condition for her to sign a document.
That these are all, that's again not true. Okay.
Okay.
This was the agreement. That was the draft. And again, please read it again, Karen.
Okay.
You could say that, did I say anything there about disbarment?
Okay, so this is a draft statement that you wrote?
No, that we had negotiated. There were already about five drafts that came back and forth between myself and her lawyer.
Okay, so it just says essentially that I have not spoken or authorized anyone to speak to media directly or indirectly regarding our personal marital problems. In this regard, blind items which appeared in the internet and a newspaper tabloid regarding amounts of money purportedly belonging to Andy Bautista that I supposedly discovered, as well as allegations about certain, I won't read this part, have not been sourced from nor proven by me. So I think that's the important part.
No, well, but you could go ahead and say about ito, no? Please read the second paragraph.
Upon the advice of Lorna Kapunan, I was instructed last November 16 to obtain from our home documents belonging to Andy and the Bautista family, which I have now returned to him.
Which he has not, because the agreement was never signed. So those documents continue being.
So in effect, her interpretation with these two paragraphs is it's a condition saying nothing was irregular. And number two,
No, it doesn't say that nothing.
That's the point.
I was never saying that. And again, as I said, but look, although uncertain, please continue to read.
Although uncertain of exact amounts, dates, and details, as I was never privy to their financial transactions, nor did I have full knowledge or control of our financial situation during our marriage, I acknowledge that I was aware that Andy's parents and siblings have been co-investing with him and making monetary placements through him even before we were married in the year 2000.
That's correct. You know, I have a document here. It shows 1998 investments of my brother. I don't want to show it yet. My brother has voluntarily said he's coming back to the Philippines.
Okay.
And that we will be holding a Bautista press conference again to be able to clear the air in respect of this matter of ill-gotten wealth.
Okay. So, I think let's...
Maybe you can also say this, okay? Please read this next paragraph.
Okay, but Andy, there's a lot of other issues.
Maybe just that.
All right. Says here that based on the draft statement, I recognize that our personal issues can be exploited by unscrupulous persons to advance their own agendas. I've reason to believe that Lorna Kapunan, who I had engaged to assist me in connection with my dissolution of marriage, has violated my trust and confidence. That's why she won't sign it.
No. She was the one who gave that language.
She did?
She did give that language.
Against Lorna?
Yes. And again, as I said, we will get people to testify. This is not invented. And this was heavily negotiated. This statement was heavily negotiated. But go ahead. As I said, there are a lot of things here that, you know, more than meets the eye.
Okay. Now, Chairman, we'll get straight to the point of allegations which actually matter with your position.
Okay.
All right, let's start with that. I'll make it quick on these parts.
Mm-hmm.
32 passbooks, which she claims have 300, close to 400 million in it. Your sal en was 176 million. It makes people question, did you lie in your sal en?
I did
what
not lie.
What was the source of this money?
Okay, as I said, okay, again, the 32 passbooks, I'm not sure.
Okay.
It is true that our family and myself have deposits with Luzon Development Bank. As to the amount, I'm not sure because, as I said, these bank books were stolen, okay? But my sal en truly reflects the statement of assets and liability and net worth on my part. As you can see from her statement, and I've been saying this all along, you know, that there are certain monies that are in the names of my father, my mother, my sister, my other siblings, and I am an end-or only because, nga, number one, I was tasked to be like the family treasurer long ago, even in the 1990s, okay? And that they've parang recognized that I have the capacity in order to invest these monies. So even the properties, okay, all the properties that belong to me are in my sal en. And it's also not true that she is not part of these properties because I am married to her. You know, she keeps on saying that I was hiding properties. That's not true. Look at my sal en now. And I can tell you that all of these properties also belong to her and were factored in when we gave the settlement offer.
Okay. Now, they're casting malice on the fact that, and you can explain this, you have BDO checks issued by you to Luzon Development Bank sometimes every other day below 500,000
mm-hmm.
in 2016 during the time that you were COMELEC chair.
Mm-hmm.
So Patricia's point is where would he be getting this money considering he works for government? There should be no other source of income for my husband.
That's right. Okay. Again, no. I don't know the factual accuracy of it. Yesterday I was told every day though that 500,000 pesos was being transferred.
Yeah.
That's a complete falsehood. Now, you're telling me now every other
something,
day?
Yeah, every other day or every day?
I'm not sure. And as I said, we need to get the documents. Okay.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you the source. And people know this, you know, that there were investments that were made by my family with Forex.
Yeah.
Okay. And again, this is a problem now within, I don't know if you've heard of this, wherein it was like a pyramid scheme.
Oh,
okay?
Okay.
So, and again, as I said, all of these will be explained in due time as to where these monies are coming from.
Okay.
Secondly, as I said, we were selling certain properties. You know, for example, yung mga checks daw from Attorney Nilo Divina. Okay. We were selling certain properties. He was paying off some of these properties.
Okay.
So, again, we will explain it in due time. But why in media? Yun ang inaano ko. Why are they doing this as a media play? Why don't you file the necessary cases in court?
Because as of today, just for the record, there are no cases.
Well, we already filed a case.
You did?
We did file a case.
What case?
We filed a case for grave coercion, for qualified theft and or robbery, and also for extortion, which is in the form of grave threats and life threats.
When did you file this case?
Yesterday.
You did?
Yes.
Okay.
With my family.
Okay. All right. Now, to move on to the other points, right, that involve your position as COMELEC chair. She said on the show, and I think in a press con yesterday, you also did say that you were getting referral fee for actually getting Smartmatic as a client of the Divina Law Office.
Oh, that, you know, complete falsehood.
All right.
My gosh, complete falsehood.
You were not getting any referral fees, any commissions.
No, okay. You know, in law practice, sometimes what happens is, okay, certain law firms would provide a referral fee if you bring in a client and help develop a relationship.
Okay,
in the past, Mr. Divina, Attorney Divina, gave me some referral. But again, it's few and far between. No?
Yeah.
And I can categorically say...
But as COMELEC chair?
No. This was before. I can never... You know, when I was COMELEC chair, I had not... Wala. But I can categorically tell you, I have not received any single centavo from Smartmatic or from Attorney Divina in respect to Smartmatic. I do know that Attorney Divina's firm has been engaged by Smartmatic, but again, Smartmatic is a big company, just like any big companies, they engage several law firms, okay? But I also know that their main law firm is Accra Law, which has been doing all their work since 2009. And let me also say, okay, when I got into my position, Karen, in 2015, Smartmatic was already there. Smartmatic was the provider of our technology in 2010, in 2013, and now in 2016. And I just came in 2015, no, 1 year before the election. It is just regular that, again, COMELEC needs to interface with our technology supplier to make sure that our elections work. So it's true that there are meetings and all that stuff.
So again, that's pertinent to your post right now, that particular accusation.
That's right. And I, you know, I'm not denying that there were meetings, okay, that have happened. But again, they have happened in an official capacity. My colleagues in the commission have such meetings as well. Senior officials meet with them on a regular basis because we have to coordinate our efforts to make sure that the elections happen well. No. Number three. Again, secret meeting in Washington, D.C., okay, in November daw. That's another allegation. It's true, we had a meeting with, I think, the number one or the number two guy of Smartmatic. But as I said, I was in a global conference. I was invited. This was 5-6 months after our elections. Tapos na yung ating halala nun eh. And in that meeting, there were other people.
Hindi secret. Okay.
Yun talaga makikita mo talagang binabahira nila ng politika because nga ang gusto nilang gawin ay sirain ang magandang halala na nangyari noong 2016.
Okay. Now, when you were PCGG chair, she found in your closet, and I saw this myself, they were in brown envelopes, employee paychecks with still cash inside, and the envelopes were dated October 2014. Basta in 2014. The question on my mind is, what would paychecks be doing in your closet?
Kaya nga ito naman, okay.
Of 2014 PCGG.
Ang allegation is they are ghost employees.
Okay.
Okay? May mga pangalan doon. At ako din nahihiya dahil, again, yung mga pangalan nila ngayon ay na buklat na sa media. Okay? But for example, and I hope he forgives you because sinabi na yung pangalan niya, no? Howard Vitas. Okay? Howard Vitas is the best friend of my brother-in-law.
Okay.
Okay? This guy is a graduate of the Rhode Island School of Design in the United States.
Okay.
I asked for his assistance in respect of trying to spruce up the COMELEC office. Mm. Kasi, di ba, konting, ano sure. Na mapaisan. He was receiving 25,000 pesos a month as a consultant. No? So, again, I don't know. I want to see ano.
Chairman, but why is it there? No, that's the point.
Ano mo? Yung baka yung envelope lang. Hindi ba kunyari, Karen, makakuha ka ng envelope from BPI. Di ba? Tapos may pera doon dati. Tinanggal mo. Ngayon minsan, iiwan mo doon, tapos lalagay mo din ng pera. Wala nang kinalaman. Itanong nyo na lang kay Mr. Vitas. Okay. Natanggap mo ba ang iyong consultancy fee o hindi? Hindi ba ganun mas madali? Yeah. Yun ang sinasabi ko na, you know, they're putting 2 and 2 together. You know, the point is that it was just an envelope. This was in 2014,
yes,
3 years
but
after.
The envelopes, Chairman, kasi had, ano eh, they were not old. Kumbaga, hindi bugbog, hindi luma, with names in front of employees.
That's correct, okay. 2014. And as I said, I've done it all the time. Na minsan, yung mga lumang envelope, linalagyan mo ng pera mo.
But it has the exact amount of what's outside. Let's say if it says 15,000, if you count what's inside, it's 15.
Oh yeah, ang tanong ko ngayon, yan hindi ko na alam. Yun ang mahirap eh, okay? Uh-huh. Sino naglagay ng 15 doon? Paano ko malalaman 15 yon? Baka planted yan. Yan ang problema, Karen, no? Ninakaw yung mga dokumento eh. At gumagawa sila ng kung ano-anong istorya, kung ano-ano yung mga pinapalabas. Yan ang disadvantage ko ngayon eh. You know, that they can easily make up these allegations. And that's why let's go to court, let's prove the authenticity of these documents. That's the proper way of doing things.
Yeah.
Instead of going to the media, and ang daming tao nang nakakawawa dito.
Yeah. Okay. Now, you know, many have tweeted and said it's so painful to hear how a domestic squabble could actually move to national media. But I think we need to stress is the reason it's on national media is because it entails you as being COMELEC chief.
That's right.
The allegations are serious as COMELEC chief. That is the context of this whole interview. So
you know, which is fine. No, and as yes, I said yes. again, as COMELEC chief, as a public official, we should be transparent yeah. and we should be open to public scrutiny. Mm-hmm. But again, I ask Karen, okay. They stole the documents November 2010, okay? At 2016. Bakit ngayon lang linalabas? Kung sinasabi nila meron daw mga pagkakamali, meron daw nakaw na yaman, bakit ngayon lang? At ang sagot ay simple lang, no? Because nga, pera-pera lang naman ito eh. Humihingi sila na mas malaking pera. I wanted to show you another document, okay? This was a copy of an impeachment complaint.
Okay.
Okay? That was sent surreptitiously by a person supposedly, ano bang pangalan dyan na ano, kung sino man yan, no?
Ivan Liu.
Ivan Liu, whoever Ivan Liu, to my sister. To my
Who
sister.
Who works in ABS-CBN Foundation?
Okay, it's a copy of an impeachment comment on June
28.
2017. Okay. And then, my mother-in-law.
So you're saying before Patricia even went to the Inquirer, this was already sent to your sister?
Sent to my sister, sent to my mother-in-law, sent to my kasi. And again, talagang to pressure me na sinasabi, oy ha, pag hindi ka magbayad, pa-impeach ka na. Yung mga ganyan,
Oo.
Tama ba yan?
Okay.
Tama ba yung ganyang, ano? Ano ba talaga sila? Ano ba, are they crusaders for what is good or right? Or is it just a money play? At sinasabi ko naman, ako naman sabi ko nga, handang ibigay kung ano dapat yung kanyang makuha.
Okay.
And again, that's why people ask, okay, bakit yung mother-in-law niya, yung kanyang sariling ina sa aking kumakampi.
Okay. All right. Before, we're gonna get to that on the second half of the show. But before we go, I wanna, you have to answer this. You said Howard Vitas was hired to spruce up the COMELEC office. So the question is, why would his honorarium be in a PCGG envelope?
Well, because he was a consultant of PCGG. Okay. And again, it's a small amount. I don't know how much was it. 15, 20,
roughly,
25,000?
I saw, 12,000. But of many envelopes.
Yeah. But again, as I said, minsan, you know, linalagyan ko yan ng pera. At minsan do, baka sila ang naglagay ng pera. Yun ang hindi ko na alam eh.
So just to clarify, they are not PCGG payroll anymore.
Because wala na, wala house. Na. Consultants na sila nung time ko as PCGG.
Yeah, but those envelopes, I'm saying, that have PCGG on them, salaries, names of people, your wife found it in November 2016. I'm asking you, Chairman, because people would wonder, why would PCGG payroll be in your home?
Hindi PCGG payroll nga. It's an envelope.
It's just envelopes. It's an PCGG. Envelope.
And I think it's two or three. You know, these are consultants.
It's a few, sir.
Oh, it's a few. Yun ang sinasabi
ko. I would have to say roughly, probably, offhand, 15 to 20, at least what I saw
15,
on the 20,000.
You know, bakit pinapalak?
No, 15, 20 envelopes or a few.
Yan, well, again, gusto ko sanang makita. Okay. Yan ang problema, again, as I said, Karen. You know, that is what is so unfair.
Okay.
You know, nanakawang ka ng mga dokumento, tapos doon, ipapakita sa, you know, I asked for an inventory of what she took. She never gave me one. I asked her, okay, let's go through the bank accounts. Let's go through the properties one by one in front of your brother. She didn't want to.
Okay.
And up to now, okay, 10 months after this thing has happened, she continues to control those documents.
Okay.
And again, she tells me now that they're going to bring it to the NBI. Ano ipadadala na sa NBI? Paano ko malalaman kung yung mga dokumentong yun ay talagang dokumento ko o ginawa nila, dinoktor nila? Yun ang unfair eh.
And is it common practice for, let's say, a PCGG consultant from, let's say, someone you've used to spruce up a COMELEC office?
It's been done.
That's been done. So, where is the payroll coming from if that's the case? Is it COMELEC or PCGG?
PCGG to. Matagal na ito, Karen. Okay. 2014 pa ito eh.
So, that's allowed?
Yeah.
Okay.
And, you know, in various government agencies were allowed to engage consultants for a nominal fee.
Okay.
Well, you know about the customs consultants, no? iba naman yon na consultant for basketball, consultant for, wala kaming ganun, no? At saka ito, konti lang, maliliit yung mga amounts in accordance with COA rules and regulations for a specific role. I don't know again how long he was my consultant, but I remember mga 3 or 4.
Okay, all right, we're gonna take a quick break. We'll be right back with COMELEC Chair Andy Bautista. Please stay tuned. All right, still with us is COMELEC Chair Andy Bautista. I know this is getting very tough for you right now
on many fronts.
Okay, but I just, before we move on to other issues, I just want you to clarify this issue. I'm going to show this. These are the PCGG envelopes that I was referring to. So, okay, I took it using my cell phone yesterday. So, essentially, they are employee statements in envelopes, names of employees, with their salaries dated October 31, 2014. When you open it, there's cash inside. Many of them are still closed, okay, are still sealed, but essentially they are employee pay slips in government. So my question was simple: why would a 2014 PCGG pay slip be in your home? All right, and you were saying, no, they're old envelopes I've used, but you're looking at them, I mean it's quite untouched, they're new in terms of the pay slip.
As I said, it is commonplace that we use old envelopes and put money there. Number two, though,
Number two,
that it's also possible that some people put those monies in there. And that's why I want to see these envelopes.
Okay. No?
Number three, okay. In fact, one of our commissioners, okay, wanted to do a NBI investigation in respect of ghost employees. And it's good, you know, that my friend Commissioner Ronald Chua is here right now in the studio. Okay, and he was with me when we went to the NBI director's office. They conducted an investigation, a full-blown investigation on ghost employees at PCGG in 2014.
So there's none?
They came out with a finding. In fact, those two people that you're referring to in those envelopes came and showed themselves to the NBI director and said, this is all again. Karen, but okay.
All right, now moving forward.
Okay.
Regardless whether you are innocent or accountable to some degree, the COMELEC as an institution, its credibility has been put in a precarious situation. I mean, you are the head of COMELEC. What is your plan, Chair? Because you're busy with the barangay elections. I mean, I saw you yesterday. And yet, you will be answering this. You'll be going to court. You'll be defending yourself. Will you then be compromising the people in COMELEC, those under you?
Alam mo, Karen, siyempre pinag-iisipan ko din yan. No? At ako, sinabi ko na to dati, no? Ako, hindi ako kapit ako sa kahit na anumang posisyon, pribado man o publiko, no? At ako parati, tinitimbang ko eh.
Okay.
Kung ako ba ay makakatulong pa o makakabigat sa isang institusyon, no? I can tell you right now, I have done nothing wrong, no? But at the same time, if I feel that, again, it will question or sort of like compromise the credibility of the institution, especially the May 2016 elections. You know, Karen, we have been feted not just here in the Philippines, but from all over the world. You know, ask all the watchdogs, PPCRV, NAMFREL, Democracy Watch, the Carter Center, COMELEC Advisory Council. You know that the Pulse Asia came out with a survey in July 2016, 1,200 Filipinos, 90% had
trust.
A positive. Internationally, there was an International Center for Parliamentary Studies awards given. COMELEC was given the Electoral Commission Body of the Year Award for the world. Basically, we were the best election management body of the year in 2016.
So this is what's tough, because your achievements and efforts are overtaken and trumped by this.
Yun na nga. Kaya nga sinasabi ko, yun ang masakit sa akin.
Yeah.
You know, yung mga personal na problema, ngayon, binabahiran ng politika. Pero dito, as I said, ito pa. Okay. Aside from that, syempre, iniisip ko rin, ang aking pamilya. Lalong-lalo na yung aking apat na anak.
Yeah. Did you explain this to them?
Well, you know, I have not fully explained it to them because, you know, 8 years old, 13, 14, they can't fully grasp.
Yeah.
In fact, si number two, sabi niya, I don't want to hear about it when I try to explain my side. Okay? But the mother has their ears. And again, I don't want to separate them from their mother because I know also that boys being boys are closer to their mother. But I've not been given a fair shake in this regard. No? And ako, mahalaga ang kanilang kapakanan dito. In the whole equation, that's what I'm trying to weigh. I'm also trying to, you know, of course, weigh my own parents. My mother is a stroke victim. Okay, she almost died 2 years ago. Now, she is not fully mobile. You know, when I talk to her, all I can see is she praying and tears in her eyes. And I don't want to subject them, my siblings, to, you know, a circus. Okay, but at the same time then, I want to clear my name because these allegations are all false. And that was, I was hoping that this would be done in a civil, in a decent manner.
Okay, Chairman. Okay,
not in the media. I don't want to try anybody in the media because that's not being fair. Let me just go to the Inquirer though, okay?
Okay,
they gave my wife, I don't know again who arranged that meeting, 2 days to present her side. Last Sunday afternoon, I got a call and said, we are running a story about you.
Yeah.
And, well, we need to hear your side. Sabi ko, can we just do it tomorrow? Because it's Sunday afternoon. And on, well, sir, we will just run the story tomorrow. And then we will just hear your side
Did
tomorrow.
You know the story?
No. Sinabi lang sa akin at that point in time. And they sabi ko, obviously, it's going to be unfair. But I had no choice. So they gave me 1.5 hours. To present my side. But, well, as you know, may video. Ibang-iba yung pagkaano yung slant eh. Na, kumbaga, parang talagang pabor. It was bias in her favor. Hindi ako binibigyan ng pagkakataon na ma-air ko yung aking panig. And, as I said, let's face it, there is a demolition job against me. Now, as to why, I think that's for people to judge. But I just hope people are going to be fair.
Do you believe, Patricia, would be against the demolition job against you in a political spectrum? Or do you believe she is, I mean, unwittingly used? I mean, you know her.
I don't know anymore, Karen.
Ah, okay.
I used to know her.
Okay.
But as you know, she thinks differently. We think differently. She supposedly has a third eye. Again, I'm not saying that's right or wrong. It's just that she sees differently. You know, when we were talking about, sabi ko, okay, paano mangyayari sa mga bata? Pag ito ay mabulat-lat sa buong mundo. Sabi niya, no, the universe will take care of them. And yung isang anak, di na buhapasok. Dahil dito. Is the universe taking care of him right now? It's not fair to them. That's the problem.
Okay,
just to be fair, sabi ko sa kanya, okay, yung custody, okay, why don't we just give the custody of the children to your mother and to your brother?
Yeah.
Because I think they will be fair to my children. So, parang she's keeping them hostage. Eh. And you know, ito pa sinasabi, I've not been providing. That's again a complete falsehood. She got money from me. Okay, $117,000, $250,000, yung mga GC, yung mga cash kinuha sa cabinet. Up to now, she has not accounted for that. Yung sasabihin na violence daw, I've never touched her in my life. In fact, ang sinasabi nga ng aking mga kapatid, kasi ang problema ko daw, masyado ako mabait. Okay, sinasabi daw kahapon, I'm controlling. How can I be controlling when she was staying out of the condo 3-4 times, you know, every night, being with whom, I don't know. Leaving the kids with me. And all of a sudden, in December, in November 2016, pucha biglang, she will stop me from coming into my own home. A home that I bought, built, with blood, sweat, and tears. It's not fair, Karen. Tapos, ano yung pala ako ng bawsi? Alam mo, ano mo dyan? Ano mo, minsan, hindi nakikita to na taong bayan. Eh. Sometimes, there's also violence against men. And I'm going to prove that in court.
So you believe, in a way, that you were the victim here?
Without a doubt.
Yesterday, Patricia said, Andy is not a victim. He has connections, he has power. That was a soundbite?
Well, again, meron naman akong mga kaibigan, no? Yeah. In the same way ikaw, Karen, meron pa din naman mga kaibigan, no? Pero bakit ako biktima dito? Biktima ako dito ng dalawang beses, no? Unang-una yung kanyang pagtataksil. Okay? Pangalawa, ito ang pangyayari nung November 2016, nung biglang pinigilan akong pumasok sa aking sariling pamamahay. Ninakaw yung aking mga gamit at gamit ng aking mga kamag-anak. Kinuha yung aking iPad at ano. At ngayon, ginagamit ito ngayon para ako siraan.
Okay. Chairman, there are viewers who have questions, but who do you suspect is behind this demolition? You out of COMELEC.
It is a big plot, no? But I also want to say this, no? For the record, the president, I think we both met with him.
Yeah.
And the president was very fair, was very kind. He gave his own insights in respect of his family life. Kung saan siya nagkulang. Sinabi niya sa amin yun na he was not a perfect father. And if he could rewind, he would do things differently. Kinausap niya ako muna eh. Kinausap niya ako, kasama ko yung kinausap niya yung mother-in-law ko na aking kasama at yung kanyang my stepfather-in-law and my sister. Hindi namin alam, nandun pala siya sa kabilang kwarto.
Yeah.
And then sinabi niya, okay, sandali lang. Okay? Sabi niya, kakausapin ko yung misis mo. So, we were surprised. Pero nung pumunta siya, kinausap niya yung misis ko, ganyan. Pero sabi niya, okay, after 20 minutes, pinatawag ako. Sabi, ikaw lang. Kayo lang tatlo ni Presidente ang mag-usap. So nag-usap kaming tatlo. And here again, the President was very kind. Nagbigay siya ng payo. In fact, even the settlement terms, ay sinabi ko sa kanya. At sinabi niya sa akin, Andy, pwede mo bang iakyat? Nagbigay pa siya ng numero. Eh.
Naging mediator pa
Naging
si Presidente.
Naging mediator pa siya, marriage counselor. Oh. At sabi ko ako, Mr. President, para lang magkaroon ng kapayapaan. Okay, basta bigyan lang ako ng pagkakataon na kung pwede installment, sige na, kung ano yung payo nyo, susundin ko.
Okay. All right. We don't have enough time for today, Chairman. Would you be willing to go through an impeachment process? Are you the kind that's willing to go through something like that? I mean, there are people that won't. There are that do. What?
You know, if it was just me, for sure I would, in order to vindicate myself. Okay, but at the same time, I recognize that there will be other people who will be brought in and it's going to be messy. So I have to weigh these things.
Yeah.
So at this point in time, I can't categorically answer your question. We'll see how it works out. Now I live day to day and just pray to the good Lord that He will take care of my family and that in the end, as I said, truth and justice will prevail.
All right, on that note, Chairman Andy Bautista, thank you so much, sir, for coming to Head Start. I'm Karen Davila. Replay of this interview is at 10:30 a.m. this morning. But that's a 30-minute replay because a lot of people ask me, we didn't see this part and all. That's a 30-minute replay at 10:30. But this will be posted on the ANC Facebook page and ABS-CB Online, the interview in full. So you can catch it there. It's also on iwanttv.com, ANC Alerts. And ABS-CBN Online Market Edge with Kathy Yang is up next.